Hello everyone, Namaste. Today is a very special and auspicious day as we are celebrating the birthday of our beloved master, Brahmarshi Chakravarti Dr. Newton Kondaveti. Today is also the foundation day of his creation, his dream project, the dream to manifest an abode of learning, seat of knowledge, to awaken the wisdom within, like the ancient Takshashila University, the Brahma Gyanapitha, the Quantum Life University. Brahmarshi Chakravarti, Dr. Newton Kondaveti, and Brahma Vid Varishtha, Dr. Lakshmi Newton, are the visionaries and honorable founders of this spectacular and distinctive university. I'm Tanmay Saha, and as the campus administrator, it's my pleasure to welcome you all to this QLU campus here in Vikarabad. The rest of the Sangha Maitreyas who reside on this campus will join me to walk you through this sacred land of QLU campus. It's a piece of heaven, trust me, and we will unfold it to you all. We are at the entrance of the campus, and this magnificent arch is the gateway. We begin this journey with the blessings of Brahmarshi Pitamaha Patriji, Guruji of Dr. Newton, who has sown the seeds of meditation amongst millions of people around the world. The statue of Patriji is surrounded by three ponds named after three masters, Buddha, Jesus, and Krishna, who represent the pinnacle soul evolution in human form. We are in the admin block of the campus. The admin block, with a built-up area of 3,000 square feet, is a double-storied building that houses the office and kitchen in the ground floor and three hotel-type room units on the first floor. Cavalier air-conditioned dormitory block is a double-storied building having a built-up area of 6,000 square feet. The ground floor is the gents' accommodation and the first floor is the ladies' accommodation. And in total, this dormitory accommodates 120 people. The Akshapatra dining hall, which is open on all four sides, has a unique architectural design with self-supporting arches. The admin block, cavalier dormitory, and Akshapatra dining hall are eco-friendly structures made using compressed, stabilized mud blocks. Over to fellow residents, Sangha Maitreya.
Namaste friends, I'm Harika, and I'm going to tell you when and where this story has begun. So in 2007, when Dr. Newton had the vision of Quantum Life University, Dr. Newton and Rajshekhar sir visited many places to find out where this vision is going to be manifested. And when they came to this place, they were invited by rabbits and peacocks. Recognizing this beautiful signal from the universe, Dr. Newton immediately decided to go ahead in acquisition of this land. On 10th June 2010, Dr. Newton, Dr. Lakshmi, Sridevi ma'am and Rajshekhar sir, along with 20 meditators, have visited this place and meditated under the one and only neem tree. At that time, this entire land was a barren land, so there was only one neem tree under which I'm standing right now. They meditated under this tree, and in the meditation, Buddha appeared to Dr. Newton and gave a message that this is the chosen place. Hence, the first ever construction on this land was built here and is named Bodhisthan. This is our favorite place and a very sacred place for us. Let us now move towards Maitri Hall. This is the Maitri Conference Hall, which was built in a very short span of 11 days of time. Every year, we celebrate the Brahma Jnana Divas, birthday of Dr. Newton and QLU, in this hall, which has a capacity of holding up to 1,000 people. We also conduct our foundational 20-day residential soul coach transformation program classes in this hall. Come, let us now move towards Mokshadham Dormitory. Another construction which was completed in a record time is the Mokshadham dormitories. These dorms were constructed in just a short span of 45 days of time. This huge structure with an area of 18,000 square feet is constructed using pre-engineered building technology along with a dual pipe system. These dorms can accommodate up to 600 people in total. Over to the next Sangha Maitreya.
Hi friends, my name is Amarnath. నేను కివెల్యూలో టెక్నికల్ ఇన్ఛార్జ్గా ఉన్నాను. ఇవాళ నేను మీకు పిరమిడ్ మరియు ల్యాబిరింత్ గురించి వివరిస్తాను. కివెల్యూలో అద్భుతమైన సీక్రెట్ ల్యాబిరింత్ను మనలోని ప్రశ్నలకు సమాధానాలు పొందుటకు నిర్మించడం జరిగింది. ఈ దారి గుండా మొదలయ్యి మధ్యస్థానంలోకి వెళ్ళి కొంత సమయం ధ్యానం చేసి మళ్ళీ తిరిగి ఇదే దారి గుండా బయటికి వస్తాము. ఇలా వెళ్ళి రావడానికి 40 నిమిషాల సమయం పడుతుంది. ఇప్పుడు మన క్యూఎల్యూకి హృదయ స్థానమైన పిరమిడ్ దగ్గరికి వచ్చాము. ఈ పిరమిడ్ పేరు శ్రేయాన్స్ దాగా పిరమిడ్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్ హాల్. ఇందులో 400 మంది కూర్చొని ఒకేసారి ధ్యానం చేసుకోవచ్చు. ఇందులో మనం వివిధ క్లాసులు జరుపుకుంటాము. ఈ పిరమిడ్లో ఇప్పటి వరకు చాలామంది ధ్యానులు అద్భుతమైన అనుభవాలు పొందారు. ఇది ఒక గొప్ప హీలింగ్ పిరమిడ్. ఇప్పుడు మన సంగమైత్రియ మిగిలిన ప్రదేశాల గురించి వివరిస్తారు మీకు. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
నమస్తే, ఐఎమ్ జ్యోతి, క్యూఎల్యూ సంగమైత్రియ, అండ్ ఐ టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ క్యూఎల్యూ కిచెన్ అండ్ అన్నదాన. దిస్ ఆస్పిషియస్ డే, విచ్ ఈస్ ద బర్త్డే ఆఫ్ అవర్ గురు బ్రహ్మర్షి చక్రవర్తి డాక్టర్ న్యూటన్ కొండవేటి అండ్ క్యూఎల్యూ ఫౌండేషన్ డే టూ, విత్ గ్రాటిట్యూడ్ టు మై గురుస్ న్యూటన్ సార్ అండ్ లక్ష్మి మేడం, I would like to show you the kitchen area where delicious food is cooked and Akshay Patra dining hall where the food is served. The kitchen is built with the capacity of preparing meals for 500 people at a time. The Akshay Patra dining hall serves 200 people simultaneously. Regular annadana is going on here for whoever visits the campus, and on a daily basis we serve food to nearly 30 people. For the program such as MBTP and SCTP, around 500 people are served food throughout the course. Every year, on the occasion of Newton Sir's birthday and QLU annual day, we serve food for more than 2,000 people from our Akshay Patra. We look forward to serving you when you visit QLU next time. Deep gratitude to our masters and all of you. Over to the next Sangha Maitreya.
Namaste friends, this is Pavan, QLU Sangha Maitreya. I am going to talk about eco-friendly constructions and technologies at QLU. Our masters encourage the use of nature-friendly constructions and technologies. Most of the constructions use eco-friendly technology. We are using solar street lights and LED lights everywhere. We are presently installing a solar power plant for our energy usage. We have dug many ponds to conserve groundwater level. We have dug the enormous Saraswati Lake having an area of 5 acres and a capacity of 15 crore liters to conserve rainwater. We have massive rainwater harvesting systems, especially at Mokshadham, where we have a sump with 2 lakh liters capacity to store harvested rainwater. We recycle used water with a sewage treatment plant, and the treated water is then used for the plants through the drip irrigation system. We have built several check dams across the natural stream passing through our campus to conserve groundwater and recharge the water table. This is the biggest check dam at QLU, which prevents the rainwater from the entire land of the living area and surrounding farms from running off. Through this check dam, the groundwater level has increased and it recharges 3 borewells near it. This is the amphitheater where we are conducting early morning meditations, open air classes, evening talks, campfires and full moon meditations. We have also performed sacred weddings here. This is the Nirvana Rooms building, which is built using hollow wire cut bricks to provide insulation from outside heat or cold. In this building, we have 36 twin sharing rooms for participants of QLU residential programs and 6 rooms for storage and maintenance. Most of these rooms were donated by QLU well-wishers. To convey our gratitude to the donors, we engrave their names in front of each room. From Nirvana Rooms, we have a wonderful valley view. This is our compound wall. The first phase construction work up to ground level basement was done with the assistance of our soul coaches through Shramdaan. Above ground level, we use natural and cost-effective stones from the quarries at Tandur. Over to next Sangamaitreya.
Hi friends, I am Bhanu. I am staying here in Quantum Life University. My work is related to spiritual agriculture and animal welfare. In spiritual agriculture, we do farming and plantation in more natural way and spiritual way. Like in organic farming, in spiritual farming also, we are not use any chemicals, fertilizers and pesticides. We meditate and communicate with the plants, which respond by growing healthy and giving greater quantity and more energetic yield. Through plant communication, we learn wonderful life lessons and spiritual lessons. Here, we are doing spiritual agriculture in 5 acres of land. At present, we are growing Tur Dal. Now in our campus, we have already planted more than 2000 plants. Here in our campus, we have 9 vanas, our gardens. Trishakti Vana, Kriya Shakti, Jnana Shakti, Ichcha Shakti, and Tulasi Vanam, Dakshinamurti Vanam, Dhanvantri Vanam, and finally Matru Vanam, Pitru Vanam, and Guru Vanam. Here also we do meditation and communicate with the plants. Each vanam or garden carries a different structure, shape, plants, and energy. We can learn and experience wonderful life lessons by spending time in these gardens. Next is animal welfare. The main intention of this area is harmoniously to coexist with animals and communicate with them. Now we have a wonderful goshala here in Quantum Life University having 22 cows. And these are all our beautiful, wonderful cows. And initially we had just 2 cows and 1 ox. Now the number has increased to 22. We use cow products like cow dung and cow urine for spiritual agriculture. We prepare Jeevamrut and Bijamrut for the fields. Here all of our cows are happy cows. We don't milk them until the cows have fed fully. We have 6 dogs, which are like our family members and the guardians of the land. Over to our next Sangamaitreya.
Hi friends, myself Moparna, and we are here at the highest vibrational spot where the much awaited sacred unique geometric structure, the Sahasrara Pyramid, would be created under the guidance of all the visible and invisible masters. The astral template of this Sahasrara Pyramid already exists here, and this is the temple of universal wisdom, the Brahma Jnana, which Quantum Life University is going to disseminate to the world. Speaking about the structure, the Sri Chakra Mandala would be the base of the pyramid, and the terrace of the Sri Chakra Mandala would be landscaped with various geometric patterns. This Sahasrara Pyramid will be composed of 1,000-petaled blue lotus representing multidimensional awareness, and the 72,000 crystals representing 72,000 nadis will be placed within the walls of the pyramid. So dear friends, do send your loving energies in manifesting this magnificent energy portal here in Quantum Life University. So we are here at another serene, sacred, energetic power spot within Quantum Life University, the Saraswati Lake. The name itself signifies the divine energies of Goddess Saraswati, the Goddess of Wisdom. The area around the lake is very meditative, and participants coming for workshops are encouraged to meditate here. Many people have reported having mystical experiences and insights while meditating here. As you can see, the Saraswati Lake is surrounded by a variety of trees and migratory birds nesting here. This lake, spreading over an area of 5 acres, has provided water to nearby villages and grazing cattle.
A path around the lake will be created as a nature walkway with benches and meditation pods.